Happy Easter to all our kids' church peeps and especially new visitors. Thank you for joining us. My name is Viv Stone and I'm the Kids Church pastor here at Christian Assembly. Welcome to our Kids Church family experience Easter celebration. And celebrate we will, because this is the most important day of all history. Easter has forever changed our lives and we can't wait to share with you just how and why. So thank you for celebrating this special holiday with us. We've got a lot of fun in store for you and your family as we laugh and learn together. It's gonna be awesome. Enjoy our video and be sure to share us with your peeps. Kids, we love you. Happy Easter. Are you ready? Here we go.
You guys ready? You sure? All right, here we go.
Yo, 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 what is up, everybody? Guys, what is up, my peeps? Welcome to the Easter Games. I promise we're going to have an excellent time. Guys, the first game we'll be playing is called the Great Jelly Bean Stack. You will need to grab a pack of jelly beans and a popsicle stick from your Easter basket to play. Now this is how the game works. First, you will put the popsicle stick in your mouth, then you will have 1 minute to place as many of the jelly beans as you can on your popsicle stick before the time runs out. Now try your best to keep them on your popsicle stick without them falling off. I know you guys can do it, but feel free to watch us play around first before jumping in and trying it for yourself at home. Now each round, Trey and I will be facing a kid. And guys, for the first game, our first challenger is...
Emerson!
Game begins in 3, 2, 1.
For the second round, I will be challenging...
Faye!
Game begins in 3, 2, 1.
welcome back, my peeps. How was that? Was that good? You guys having fun? All right, well guys, let's keep the games going. The next and final game is called Face the Peeps. Now, to play this game, you'll need the peeps from your Easter basket. And this is how the game will work, all right? You will have 1 minute to stick as many of the peeps on your face as you can, all right? You can try and stick the whole thing on, or you can break it apart and stick the pieces to your face. Now, when the time is up, let's see how many peeps you were able to stick on your face. I can't wait to see. As always, please feel free to watch us play around first before jumping in and trying it for yourself at home. Now, for the first round of this game, I will be challenging
Christian.
Game begins in 3, 2, 1.
For the second and final round of our games, I will be challenging
Game begins in 3, 2, 1.
Feels weird, huh? is rocking.
Oh yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
Keep on going.
Everyone, I am so excited that you've joined Kids Church Online to celebrate the most important event ever. You might be thinking, okay, Becca, come on. Easter's great, super fun, lots of candy, but most important day ever? Really? You guys, it's true. There are a bunch of fun ways that we can celebrate Easter, but it's about so much more than chocolate and eggs and peeps and jelly beans and vacuuming up fake grass for weeks. What happened on Easter is actual history. It's the time that God made a bridge between himself and us. And it means that no matter what is happening right now, we can have peace. And it means that we can look forward to what will happen next absolutely secure, because God loves us and he's faithful. Easter is the greatest reason to celebrate. And like I said, there are so many different ways to celebrate. It's kind of crazy the way we're celebrating Easter this year with us here and you guys out there in your own homes. It's pretty amazing what's possible today. I thought it might be fun to look back and see some of the ways that people have celebrated Easter in the past. Before we take a look, though, I have a question to ask you. How many of you are watching this Easter service in your PJs? I bet some of you are, which is great. Did you know that one of the ways they celebrated Easter when our great-grandparents, or maybe your great-great-grandparents were young, was that they dressed really fancy on Easter? They did that to properly observe the special day. Another thing that people used to do is they would have an Easter parade.
Positions, everyone. Chin up. Eyes forward. Let's go!
might feel really connected to Easter, because we know that Easter is about the time that something very important got rolled away. Do you remember what it was?
The Easter egg roll.
Okay, not exactly what I was thinking, but I'm curious.
So, the Easter egg roll is a national tradition. In fact, the White House has held an annual Easter egg roll since 1878. We have Rutherford B. Hayes to thank for that. This is how it's going to work. In front of both me and MJ, we will have an extreme Easter egg roll ramp. On go, we will have exactly 1 minute to roll as many eggs as we can down the extreme Easter egg roll ramp and into our basket. Which is not easy because we all know eggs are not round, they're egg-shaped. And then, you know, at Kids Church, we always have to add a little extra to our challenges. Get it? Extra? Yeah. In order to roll eggs down the ramp, we're going to have to first catch them as they're being thrown to us. We can't pick up any eggs that hit the ground. We can only use ones that we've caught. And again, we only have 1 minute to do this. This might get a little messy. You guys out there, are you ready to cheer us on? Here we go, in 3, 2, 1, go! I love all of this celebrating, but do you know what I love even more? I love the reason we're celebrating in the first place. Easter is the day set aside to remember the most amazing thing that's ever happened. This day changes everything for everyone. It's about broken things being put back together. It's about more love than we can even imagine. So I thought today would be a perfect time to hear the story all over again. Like, really hear what it may have sounded like if you were right there. And to help us, I've got this pretty cool basket of Easter eggs. Let's start our story today from the beginning and see how these eggs might help us tell it. Listen to this. Not what you were expecting, right? I know what you were thinking. Well, that was 3 months ago. But the truth is, our story today can't happen without Christmas and the birth of Jesus. From the very beginning, when Adam and Eve turned away from God, our world has been broken. But even then, God had a plan to restore us, to make things right. On that first Christmas, God, the God who made the entire universe, chose to send his own son as a tiny baby to live here with us. How crazy is that? God became a human. He experienced everything that we do. But Jesus didn't stay a baby. He grew up. He did amazing things.
I can see.
I can see.
I'm walking.
Like healing people who hadn't been able to walk or see since they were born. Or this one time on a lake. Jesus ended a wild storm with just the sound of his voice. The Bible says he got up and ordered the wind to stop. He said to the waves, "Quiet, be still." Then the wind died down and it was completely calm.
That's so amazing. Many people loved Jesus and the crowds followed him to hear him teach. He told people how much God loved them and he called them to love God and love others. His closest followers, the disciples, believed that Jesus was the one that God had promised to free his people. They thought Jesus was about to become a wonderful king over everything. I don't think the disciples were surprised when Jesus entered Jerusalem to celebrate Passover. A giant crowd showed up to cheer for him.
Hosanna! Hosanna! Hosanna!
People waved palm branches and threw their cloaks down in front of him. But the religious leaders saw Jesus as a threat to the way that they had done things. They made a plan to crush the work that Jesus was doing. The religious leaders paid one of Jesus' disciples to betray him. For 30 pieces of silver, Judas agreed to help them arrest Jesus later that night. It looked like God's plan was breaking down. That evening, Jesus shared a meal with all the disciples. Jesus took a basin of water, and he washed his friends' feet, even the feet of Judas, the person who would betray him. Jesus told the disciples he was going to leave them soon, but he would return. They didn't understand. Wasn't Jesus supposed to be the promised king? After dinner, in the Garden of Gethsemane, Judas betrayed Jesus to the religious leaders. Jesus was arrested and taken to stand trial before the high priest. False witnesses told lies about him, and even one of Jesus' closest friends, Peter, denied knowing him. The religious leaders couldn't sentence Jesus to die, so they sent him to the Roman governor, Pilate, who finally gave in to the crowd and had Jesus beaten and sentenced to death. Jesus was forced to drag his own cross, made of two heavy beams of wood. Bleeding and sore, he dragged it to the top of a hill, where the Son of God was nailed to the cross. Jesus hung on that cross and died. The sky went dark. Jesus' body was taken down, wrapped in cloths, and laid inside a tomb. A huge rock was placed in front of the opening. It looked like Jesus' mission had failed. His friends were devastated. For 3 days, they hid out with no idea of what to do. Everything that had seemed so right had gone so wrong. It was terrible. It was quiet. It was scary.
And if the story ended there, we wouldn't be here today. But in the darkness and brokenness, God was still at work. On the third day, an angel threw open the stone that blocked the entrance to the tomb.
It's him! The stone is the Lord! He is risen!
Jesus returned to life. The broken pieces started to come together. All the mess started to make sense. God was using all of it to fix the brokenness that kept us separated from him. Jesus is alive. He lived the perfect life. Then he willingly chose to die, taking the punishment for the wrong things that we've done. He took all the broken pieces of our lives and made a way for us to live forever with God. Because he didn't stay dead, he came back to life. And because he did that, that means that he can offer us new life. A new life with God that starts now and will last forever. He offers us forgiveness because he paid the penalty for our sin. Guys, it's that simple, that beautiful, that amazing. Choosing to follow Jesus doesn't mean that everything will be perfect in your life, but it does mean that you can trust that God will make everything right in the end. Guys, God loves you all so very much, every single one of you, and he has done everything possible for you to be his friend. And he doesn't want another day to go by without you choosing to trust and follow him. And the way that you do that is you just pray and tell him that's what you want to do. If there's anyone watching who has not done that, this Easter, right now, is the perfect time. I'm going to give you all a chance right now. We're all going to pray together. And if you want to make Jesus your Savior, then repeat this prayer after me. Let's pray. Dear God, thank you for loving me so much and sending Jesus. Thank you that he died on the cross to take the punishment I deserved. I accept his sacrifice for my sin, and today I choose to follow you. Thank you for your gift of forgiveness and new life. Help me every day to love and obey you. In Jesus' name, amen. For those of you who prayed that prayer for the very first time, I want you to know that I'm so excited, and not just me, everyone here at Kids Church are so excited. The angels in heaven are literally rejoicing right now, and we want to know about it. So have your mom or dad go to this website and click on I Made a Decision and fill out the info. Then keep watching the mail because we're going to send you something to get you started in your lifelong journey of following Jesus. Man, guys, this is so awesome. Honestly, don't want this party to end. I think we should just, you know, celebrate Easter just a little bit longer, just a little bit longer. And the truth is that even after we're done celebrating online, Easter is something that we can celebrate every day of our lives. It's the greatest thing that has ever happened. Jesus came back to life so that we could all have life forever. Y'all, that's a reason to celebrate. So I need everyone to stand up, moms, dads, brothers, sisters, the dog too, yep. Guys, let's go out singing. Happy Easter, everyone. Let's celebrate. There's a reason.
There's a reason why the darkness runs from light. There's a reason why we stand and now forgiven. Jesus is alive. There's a reason why.